Welcome to ReThink, the podcast that empowers you to challenge your existing beliefs and embrace new, more productive ways of thinking. Here at ReThink, we believe that the key to self-fulfillment lies in shattering old thought patterns and adopting new mindsets that support personal growth and empowerment. With expert guests and thought leaders from a wide range of fields, we explore strategies and insights that can help you achieve success and fulfillment in all areas of your life. From relationships to career, business ownership, and health, you are the source of your own success. We're just here to help you tap into your true potential and create a brighter future. So join us on the journey of personal growth and empowerment, and let's rethink what's possible for our lives. So it's really important for us to know how our brains work. The reason being is because once we figure that out, then we can make it work on our behalf. Our brains are very, very powerful tools, probably one of the more powerful tools that we have outside of our subconscious mind. And they are constantly working. Our brains are constantly working to shape our reality. So in this episode, what we're going to do is explore the functions of the brain, especially when it comes to beliefs, perceptions, and ultimately creating our environment, our reality. So your brain, coupled with your subconscious mind, is designed to filter information and focus with what aligns with what you believe, your dominant belief. Your brain will filter and focus on the things that you believe to be true. So when you intentionally adopt a belief like I'm healthy and I'm abundant, and what your brain does, it begins to look for things to support that. It begins to look for things to say that this is true. It reinforces your beliefs. So they become deep-seated beliefs. It becomes a part of your character. And of course, it becomes a part of even your faith and how you're living your life. Now, this process has a name. It is a scientific name. It is referred to as the reticular activating system, RAS. We talked about this before, but I'm going to talk about it in a little different way today. The reticular activating system acts as a filter. Again, it highlights what is relevant based on what you believe. So again, whatever you believe, your brain is going to go out to seek and focus on those things to make it true. So if you believe that you're abundant, again, your brain starts noticing opportunities, resources, connections that align with abundance. And simultaneously, your subconscious mind, which really is the most powerful tool in my estimation, your subconscious mind, because it never sleeps, it's always working on your behalf. It works behind the scenes. And what it's doing is orchestrating circumstances and things that we call coincidence to bring about your desired outcomes. That's what your subconscious mind doing. If you think of your brain or your subconscious mind or your conscious mind as the gatekeeper, your subconscious mind, which once it gets into your subconscious, it just begins to, you know, bring about these coincidences to make things happen for the desired outcome. Your brain and understanding how it works become very critical, because you don't want anything past the gate that you don't want to actually come into your existence. So this process works both ways. So instead of saying you're abundant, you could be saying, hey, I don't have enough. So what your brain will do, it'll seek out evidence to make that true as well. You start looking around, you start noticing gaps in, you know, resources and not having enough. And also, not only do you not have enough, but, you know, my neighbor and these other people on TV. And so you'll begin to see more and more of that. So understanding this mechanism, it allows you to intentionally shift your beliefs. This is an intentional act, because we are achievers. We are folks that are looking to be not, you know, ultimately in control, but yes, to be able to shape our lives and to be wise about how to do that. We're to be knowledgeable. We are to use what we have in order to get the things that we want. So we can rewire our subconscious and we can create the reality that aligns with what we say that we want. But we've got to understand how these tools work. The first one is your brain. Here's some key takeaways. The power of your belief, it is exceptional. It is absolutely exceptional. If you think about the one thing that all religions have had in common, it is their insistence on a level of faith and belief. Why? Because it doesn't really matter what you have faith in or what you believe in. Your brain is strong enough to see evidence to make it true. So your belief acts as an instrument for your brain or instructions for your brain. And it influences what you notice and how you interpret your environment. So you can have two people in the same environment, but they have very different beliefs. They're going to interpret that same environment in two different ways. That's the power of your belief. The role of the ROS, or the reticular activating system, this part of your brain filters out distractions and it focuses only on what you deem important, shaping your experience. It's going to reinforce what you say you believe. So if you believe, for example, and I hope that you do, that people are good by nature and that there's more light in the world than darkness, then you'll see light. You'll see light. But you could take the, you know, other side of that coin and you'll see more darkness. What is the subconscious mind's role in all of this? Key takeaway. Your subconscious mind creates a chain of events. Your brain and your subconscious mind sort of work together. One lets information pass through. The other begins to create based on the information that it receives. And the subconscious mind creates a chain of events. Let's call them opportunities that can transform your reality. It aligns with your dominant belief. Your subconscious mind is going to create events down. If you've got a strong dominant belief that you're unhealthy and you can't get through this particular health challenge, your subconscious mind is going to create events that support that. And your brain is going to notice things as well. It's going to reinforce that. And the last thing is using the knowledge that we get from this exercise by consciously directing our thoughts and beliefs. And that's the whole point of this podcast today, is we now know how our brains work. So we must, from an intentional standpoint, focus on only what we want and measure it, reinforce it so that we get more of that, so we can create more of that. So what we're going to do today is talk about some daily practices to help to rewire the way that you're thinking. But more than that, I wanted to ensure that you understood from a scientific standpoint why this is important. This doesn't have to be a very long discussion. It's just a matter of you knowing and agreeing that this is science and this is what your brain does. And maybe even take an inventory over your life and experiences that you have and say, hey, how did I get to that point? What was I thinking? What was I thinking? How did I get to be so infatuated with this person? What was I thinking? How did I get so upset with the situation or this person? What was I thinking? The important thing is going to always be, or the start at least, of what you're thinking, because the thoughts come first, words, and then usually actions. And actions are what creates our environment. So let's start at the beginning. What were you thinking? I want to give you some practices today that is going to help you take this information, put it into a 30-day practice that's going to help you to begin to see some changes. And when you see those changes, you want to identify and you want to cement them with, you know, thought markers. We're going to call them thought markers. I'm going to borrow that from our friend Tufti the Priestess. If you've not heard of Tufti the Priestess, I'll put a link into our show notes so that you can link out and take a look at that book. But it is a very impactful book. This information is not coming from there, but now that I brought that up, I don't believe in coincidences. I think that I should begin to share some information from that transurfing environment, because it's basically the same thing. The power of your mind, the power of your beliefs, the power of your subconscious mind. And the reason this is important is because it gives you a level of confidence and control. You have the ability to affect your own life. There's nothing more stressful, I think, to an individual than for them to believe that they don't have control over their own lives. Someone else is affecting the course of my life. And I just don't believe that to be true. Now, I do know that we are in circumstances, situations, and events that we don't desire. But we've got to go back and do the work and say, how did I get there? Collectively, you know, sometimes there's a school project. You know, here in the U.S., we just had elections not long ago. That's a class project. So these events, sometimes, although we're included, there's a bigger... can still be controlled.
Let's take a quick break.
Hey guys, we're going to get you back to that exciting podcast very soon, but I wanted to break in and just let you know that we have relaunched, revamped, revitalized our 31 Days to New Beginning. It is a powerful step-by-step course. It is designed to help you to reset your mindset, to build new habits, and yes, create lasting positive change in your life. Over the span of 31 days, you'll be guided through daily lessons and journaling prompts and even actionable exercises that are going to help you to break free from limiting beliefs. It's going to help you to gain clarity on your goals and also help you to develop the confidence you're going to need to pursue your life's dreams. So whether you're feeling stuck or you're simply ready for a fresh start, the course, 31 Days to New Beginning, it's going to provide you with the tools, the strategies, and the support that you're going to need to transform your life from the inside out. So why don't you start the journey today? Go over, click on 31 Days of New Beginning, and step into a new chapter of growth, of purpose, and fulfillment. Let's get back to our podcast. And maintain through your a way of thinking. And so that's what we're going to focus on today. So guys, welcome in. Very long intro, but I wanted you guys to really know what we're talking about today. And also want you to go into the show notes and click on that one link. It's going to take you out to several different spots where you can support the podcast, you know, download whatever you want to download in terms of digital things that we have. There's a 30-day Prove Me activity that's going to be a part of this. And it's going to be week 1, 2, 3, and 4. And what we're going to do is to prove this information. I'm not saying proving it right or proving it wrong. This is a scientific method. We're going to take what we're talking about today and put it in action. And you determine if this is true for you. Okay? You determine if what you think and believe after doing these exercises prove to change your environment based on what your brain does and how it works, and of course, your subconscious mind. Prove it to yourself. And then you can tell me in the comments, is this worked or not? So there are some daily practices that help to rewire your brain. We're going to get into that. And I just want to welcome you guys aboard. I really appreciate the support. I thank you guys so much for continuing to reach out to the show through comments on YouTube and through your text message. Please go ahead. Keep sending us a text. If you got show ideas, things you want to know about, I'd love to do some research on your behalf and see what we can do. But let's get going. Affirmations with feeling. Affirmations with feeling. That means repeating the affirmations and really reflect on your desired reality. Like, what is it that you really want? If you say I'm worthy of abundance, and does it feel true to you? Does it feel right to you? And listen, sometimes some of us are so far from abundance, we don't know what abundance feels like. And we feel like in order for us to complete this exercise, we need to know what abundance feels like. No. What does, first of all, your definition of abundance, let's check that out. And then secondly, let's feel better. So let's say we just give a simplified definition of abundance. Abundance, again, I'm going to quote Basar, which is your ability to do what you want when you want, you know, your ability to have what you need when you need it. That truly is abundance. So let's start there. And we don't have to go into a multimillion and all the other kind of stuff unless you just want to do it. But I'm just saying some people are so far from that, they've never had a influx of a lot of money. So they don't know what that feels like. So we're talking about replicating the feeling. They find it hard to do. So let's just find the feeling of freedom. Let's just find the feeling of freedom. That is abundance. Why do we want the money in the first place? We want to be free. We want to be able to go where we want, do what we want, whenever we want, help who we want. That is freedom. So let's take it down from all of the external stuff. Let's create a feeling of freedom. Affirmations with feeling. The second thing is visualization. You begin to tell yourself a certain thing, and then you begin to see it within your mind's eye, what we call in our mind's eye, our imagination. Spend some time every day, 5 to 10 minutes every day, simply visualizing the one thing that you want to achieve or to have an outcome or to obtain. Okay, we're not going to do multiple things at a time. Let's do one thing at a time. Let's focus on that one thing. We're going to affirm it, and then we're going to visualize it. What is that one thing that you would like to see in the next 30 days happen for you, your family, your loved ones, whatever? Is it something in your body health-wise? Is it a relationship? Is it more money to put forth to your business? Is it a promotion, you know, on your within your career path? What is it that you would like to see in the next 30 days? Visualization is going to be a big, big part of that. Next is our gratitude practice. Let's train our brain to focus on what's positive by listing 3 things each day that we are grateful for. This helps to rewire the brain. What we're telling our brain is that we are not in lack. We do have. Now, you may not have as much as you want or exactly what you want, but you do have. And so you do have some resources. So be thankful for what you do have. And practicing gratitude helps to rewire your brain into a level of belief that you are abundant or you are healthy or whatever the thing you're trying to attract. Be grateful. Question your beliefs overall. If nothing else you've learned from this podcast, you should know that we question every nook and every corner as it relates to what's been told to us. I don't care who told it to you. These education, religion, politics, all of these are systems, and you've got to question everything to figure out what do you truly believe. Sometimes we're fed limiting beliefs, information, and we hold on to them. So if there's a limiting belief within you, ask yourself this: is this true? Is it true? And then you can replace it with an alternative and a more empowering belief. But if you find that, you know what, I've always had trouble, you know, dating or I've always had trouble, you know, with money. Ask yourself, is that really true? Is that really true? And does it have to remain true? Replace your limiting beliefs with a more empowering belief. And then lastly, when the wins start to come in, and they will, celebrate them. Celebrate small wins, celebrate large wins. And I want you to document it in 2 ways. Number one, I want you to document it with what I said earlier and that I took from Tutu the Priestess, which is a thought marker. What does that mean? That means within your mind, you create a space for this event. Let's say you graduated from college and you did this in your 30s or 40s. You went back to school and this is something you've always wanted to achieve and you did it. In your mind, always remember that day where you guys went out to eat, what was playing on the radio, whatever, but make it a special memory for you. We all have them, right? The first time you went to Disney World or the first birthday party you had or, you know, your wedding reception or your wedding day. Those are thought markers. Why? Because a lot of things we forget, but those things that are very key and very important to us, we tend to remember because we have placed a thought marker there. So replace the thought marker there. The second thing I want you to do is actually write it down in your journal. Celebrate it. Write it down in your journal. Acknowledge the small successes. Acknowledge the big ones before you move on, you know, to the next part of your goal. So those are the daily practices that we're going to incorporate in order to get to where we want to go. Now, like I said, I'm going to have a 30-day prove me activity sheet. And I've got to figure out how we're going to do this because I want to track everybody's progress. You know, I want you to be able to track your progress, better said. So I think I'm going to create it in Google Sheets. And sometimes that's a little, you know, but I'm going to do it nonetheless. And so by the time this podcast goes out, it should be done and ready for you to connect to or download or whatever the case may be. So let's walk through it really quickly. This is something that can help you just pragmatically. This is something that can help you change your life in a very non-judgmental or emotional way. What is it? What am I trying to say? Basically, this is just this is simple, but you know, this is a big deal, but you can do it and you can start seeing changes like immediately. Like we don't have to jump and shout to say, hey, you realize this is how your brain works. And maybe you didn't know this, but if you keep thinking like this, you're going to keep getting that. If you want to get this, you've got to think like that. And it's just as simple as that. And if you do these activities every day for the next 30 days, you have an opportunity to change your modus operandi as it relates to how you think. And if you do that, you have a very good chance of changing your environment, changing where you are in your life. And the ultimate prize is that you did it. You did it. It empowers you. It gives you confidence that I can do this again. I can focus on something different. Maybe you got out of your health challenge and you did it using this practice. Now you want to be in a relationship. Use the same technique. Make it your modus operandi. This is my everyday deal. You know, it's kind of like me with, I used to tell people I did intermittent fasting. It's just my lifestyle now. I don't even think about it. I don't even, unless somebody brings it up, I don't even think about it. So let's do the same thing with our 30-day prove me test. So let's jump into it real quick. I'm going to go over it briefly, and I'll have a form for you guys where you can download it. All right. So in week one, what it looks like we're going to do is we're going to start off at the beginning, which is setting our intentions. Each morning, we're going to write down a positive belief or affirmation about something that you want. And I'm suggesting you only do one thing at a time. So write down that positive affirmation, that positive belief about that thing, the thing that you want to create or experience. Here's an example. I am abundant, or I attract opportunities for financial growth. Every day, I attract financial opportunities for growth. That is our thought for the next 30 days. That's our belief. What are we going to do? We're going to spend 3 minutes visualizing it already true. See yourself. What does that mean to you? If you attract financial opportunities every day, see people coming to you. See people offering you, you know, opportunities, money, other resources, increase in your salaries, whatever it is, begin to visualize this as true. And then feel the emotions of the gratitude and the joy and the elation that you have because this is true. So three things. Affirmations, we're going to write down that one thing that we want. And the example we gave was that we attract opportunities for financial growth every day. How would we feel? Because that's true. And then we're going to feel the emotions of the gratitude, of the joy, of the elation. At the end of week one, what I want you to do is reflect on each day and write down the moments or the events that may have changed, that may have been thought markers based on what your new belief is. Week two. We're going to engage the reticular activating system. We're going to engage the reticular activating system. What does this mean? We're going to write down 5 things daily that align with our affirmation or goal. What did we see in the last week? What did we see today that align with our goal? If our affirmation is that I attract opportunities for financial growth, what did you see today? What did you hear today? What happened today that reinforces this belief? Write it down. The practice here is to repeat the affirmation during your quiet moments throughout the day. So we're going to do the affirmations when we wake up in the morning because we got to get our day set, you know, to where we want it. But throughout the day, you know, you can write it down, you can repeat it to yourself, but it needs to be sort of a constant flow, a constant vibration of that particular thought. I attract opportunities for financial growth easily. And I do it every day. Every day, people come up to me with different opportunities, different networking, different types of things are happening to me all the time. And I'm abundant. I'm prosperous. Continue to think that throughout the day. So that's week two. That's a pretty simple exercise, but we're going to do it for 7 days. Week three, is we're going to begin to take inspired action. We spend a lot of time affirming and then visualizing, and then hopefully you're still doing your meditation and mindfulness. Now we're going to start to hear some instructions on what it is that we need to do and how we need to do it. And that's when we're going to take inspired action that aligns with your goal. Again, if your affirmation is about health, for example, go for a walk or prepare a very healthy meal. If your affirmation is about health, go for a walk. Go for a walk. And even go for a walk in a place that you don't usually walk, where there are other people. The practice here is that you want to visualize how this action brings you closer to your desired outcome. You know that by putting healthier food into your body, for example, that you are getting healthier. May not lose all the weight today, but you're on track to get to where you want to go. This reinforces your belief. This reinforces your belief, and we know progress is happening. The last thing in the last week, week four, is we're going to reflect and we're going to refine, because we're going to start all over again the next 30 days. Look back over the month. What patterns or what changes have you noticed? Write them down. Write about what you focused on in that last 30 days. Did your focus shift? Create a vision board if you like. Create a vision board or a digital collage, you know, in your device, because it's so easy to open our phones a lot of times, look at our photos. Create a vision board there. Create, put in a little folder, you know, all the things that you want to have. And then just kind of look at them periodically. But that's a 30-day prove me test. And that keeps us focused on a particular path. Now, I'm going to say this and then we're going to kind of head out, because this is kind of lead us into a whole nother podcast. If you made it all the way through, this is just a bonus for you. And thank you for doing that. And that thought is this: where your attention goes, your energy flows. And I really want you to think about what's going on in the world we live in today. Everything and everyone is fighting for your attention. And there must be a reason why. Your attention is incredibly valuable. The good news, it belongs to you. And you can reclaim it. You can reclaim it. I know you think you're going to miss out on something if you don't open TikTok or Instagram today, but you're really not. I know you think you're going to miss out on something if you don't turn the TV on today, but you're really not. I know you feel like if I'm irresponsible for not watching the news because I'm not. No. This is information that's been fed to you so that you can support the systems that are in place. And marketing, people put a lot of money in marketing for a reason, because it works. Because it works. Wherever they can get people's attention, that's where they can get folks to do what they want them to do, particularly buy something. What I'm suggesting to you today is if you held on to your own attention and you use that energy for yourself and not point it in to someone else, you could change, upgrade, revise. You could use that energy for yourself. You could do so many things with your own attention. But if your attention is split and divided and going multiple places, you know, Hulu here and Disney Plus there, and then I'm on TikTok and now I'm on Instagram, and before I go to bed tonight, I got to turn the news on. You haven't done anything for yourself. You've simply been distracted all day. All day. And you've not done anything for yourself. So what I'll suggest you do is to begin to get control of your attention and place it where you know it will benefit you the most. And that's on you. Put your attention on you. The things that we talked about today, your beliefs and how you can focus your beliefs to be beneficial for you, put your attention there. And I think you'll see the change and the results that you want to see in your life. None of this is easy. If it was, everybody would be doing it. But once you get going, you're going to be part of that small group of people that walk the narrow path. the folks that listen and watch this podcast. So I'll give you early congratulations on the progress that you're going to make and the life changes that are afoot. And I thank you guys so much for joining me yet again on ReThink Podcast. If you haven't done so already, please go ahead and subscribe to the podcast. I'll be back again very soon with another great podcast. So have a good one. That's all for today's episode of ReThink. We hope that you've enjoyed this exploration of new ideas and perspectives and found valuable insights and strategies that you can apply to your life. Remember, you are the source of your own success and fulfillment. And by embracing new ways of thinking, you can unlock your true potential and, yes, create the life that you truly desire. Now, if you've enjoyed this episode, we encourage you to support the podcast by sharing it with your friends, your family members, your loved ones and associates, and even your followers on social media. Also, leave us a review on your favorite podcast platform. Lastly, don't forget to check out our show notes for free downloads and empowering ebooks that can help you on your journey of personal growth and empowerment. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. We look forward to exploring more ideas and insights with you in the next episode of ReThink.